Would you like to know what the secret split is inside of your brain, my brain, everybody's brain that you know, but also in our society? Well, then watch this video to the end and you'll find out exactly what that is. Hi, my name is Jesse. Welcome to the channel Open Source Owners, where we talk about what if humans had an owner's manual? Wouldn't that be great? I certainly think it would. And this is part of what would be in that owner's manual. Everybody knows the brain is split in half, left hemisphere, right hemisphere, but what you don't know, and what really kind of is not talked about a lot in neuroscience, is the functionality of these hemispheres. And there's been interesting studies and experiments and just like phenomena of human existence where people have lost certain access to parts of their hemispheres. And we've learned a lot about what the hemispheres do. Now, the key takeaway is we want to synthesize and let the hemispheres work together, both individually, collectively, and at a global level. Hint, we are currently not doing that. One hemisphere dominates this world, this society, and I guess I'll let you figure that one out as we go. So the left hemisphere is detail-oriented and has narrow attention, is able to sharply focus on a particular thing like hunting, etc. Allows us to use language and to make tools to really grasp the world and pin it down. It allows us to get stuff accomplished. It's very important. The body in the sort of construction of the left hemisphere, the human body is just an assemblage of parts. It's not like this connected spiritual thing. It's just parts, and the parts are meant to be used. And crucially, this hemisphere lives in a closed, sort of dead worldview, but that allows us to grasp things, get things done, make war, of course, and money, but also to build houses and cars and like computers and stuff. So again, I hope it's clear we're not demonizing one side over the other. You don't want to go to a neuroscientist and say, doctor, take out one hemisphere of my brain. That would be ill-conceived. The hemispheres both do important things. It's just who is dominating the show. That ends up becoming the question. And the left hemisphere is really information dense. So if we now live in a world of total information, but does that equate to higher degrees of wisdom, higher degrees of empathy, higher degrees of quality of life? I think the obvious answer is no. So the left hemisphere is really dominating the world as we now know it. What about the right hemisphere? What is the right hemisphere doing? The part of the brain that's in between the left and the right hemisphere is called the corpus callosum. Now, interestingly, the corpus callosum is sort of the gateway sending of information between the two sides. It allows both hemispheres to communicate with each other. And if we practice meditation, the corpus callosum actually gets bigger and thicker, which allows more information, more balance of the brain. And in fact, in certain forms of meditation, you can see both hemispheres rising and falling in terms of gamma waves and alpha wave activation. And that's mediated through the corpus callosum. So certain practices, contemplative practices, focused attention practices like meditation or yoga, those practices will actually build the pathway that allows the hemispheres to talk and allows ultimately wisdom to flourish in individuals and then collectively. So the right hemisphere is really more of a sustained but open attention, broad areas of attentional capacity, sort of a vigilant and alert, aware of the larger world, and it can see context and complexity and meaning and metaphor and body language and facial gestures and that type of thing. It's contextualizing the world. The body in this worldview that the right hemisphere embodies is really connected deeply to the living world. So we are enmeshed in a framework, a fabric, a life matrix, as I call it, with all other living beings all the way through the universe and back down to us individually. That is the domain of the right hemisphere. The left hemisphere cannot conceptualize the world in that way. So this hemisphere lives in a vibrant, life-filled world of wonder and universal connection, but it is hard for us to get things accomplished with just the right hemisphere activated. So we would not really build houses very well or pay our bills very well or, you know, be able to put food on the table as regularly. This is more of just like living in the moment sort of part of the brain. And this brain, this aspect of the brain is involved in sensation. Okay, so what mediates the two hemispheres? We cannot have a split brain. We cannot have a society built on one side of the brain or the other side of the brain more regularly, right? And that is the prefrontal cortex or the frontal lobe or the neocortex, however you want to call it. Now, the frontal lobe or the prefrontal cortex gives us distance from our split brain and allows us to both deceive others. So the part of our brain that becomes Machiavellian and deceptive and, you know, duplicitous and wants to sort of dissemble information and hide information to one's advantage, That is involved in the left hemisphere, right? But it's the frontal lobe that sort of pulls back and says, hold up, should we be doing this? Is that smart? So it's the frontal lobe that allows us to sort of make the decision, yes, I'm gonna lie to this person, I'm gonna misrepresent something, I'm gonna get mine, and let the other person deal with it. But it's also the prefrontal cortex that allows us to have empathy for others. So because the prefrontal cortex can pull back on any of the sort of, I guess, the downsides or the drawbacks of living more predominantly in one hemisphere versus the other, it allows us to pull back and actually fuse them together. Again, in therapy, we call this wise mind. The combination of the logical and the emotional mind is sort of the wise mind, and it has to be mediated through sort of this sort of referee or judge or wisdom maker that we all are innately born with. In another video, we called this the wise old owl. So the wise old owl shows up when we attentionally and intentionally bring it online, and it allows us to understand the sort of like negative sides of living too dominantly in one hemisphere or the other. Now, as everybody will probably be wondering, but I thought the left hemisphere was associated with right-handed stuff, which is logic and math, and then the right hemisphere is associated with left-handed stuff, which is associated with creativity and, being a great artist or something. Well, not exactly true. The brain is more complicated than that. We need both hemispheres for imagination, creativity, also reason, also wisdom, the ability to pay your bills. It takes all hemispheres to do it. Now, the brain is a special organ because you can lose literally 50% of your brain and still remap the brain to do basic connectivity issues in the connectome of the brain that allows you to do basic things that you need to do. Okay, so how does this affect society? Well, Einstein may have said it best. The intuitive mind is a sacred gift, right? So that's the right hemisphere. And the rational mind is a faithful servant. So that's the left hemisphere. We have created a society that honors the servant, but it's forgotten the gift. And I don't know about you, please leave comments below, but I certainly have felt growing up and going to school and stuff like that, that is entirely true. The individualized sacred gifts that we all carry and are innately born with, and if you can tolerate this, that we are sort of given due to the spiritual nature of our reality. And even if you don't believe that, just your intuitive natural gifts as a child, those are not honored, those are not grown, those are not nurtured. In fact, it almost seems like society is trying to stop, inhibit, get rid of our sacred individualized gifts in lieu of being better citizens, more obedient, more able to follow rules, more able to just sort of show up to a job that is 100% uninspiring, or live a life of sort of quiet servitude and quiet desperation where it does suck. We just do get older and die and suffer. And that's not a life worth living. Now, my channel and my focus is all about helping others and connecting with others who are trying to create a life worth living. And beyond that, trying to really change society so that we come back to more of what Einstein was talking about. Anything, it is the right hemisphere that we want to be more dominant. Now, of course, I say that very hesitantly because we don't want anything to be dominant, really. We want it to be a balance. We need to use both hemispheres in a balanced way by using and growing a society that really honors the neocortex and being owners of ourself in the truest sense of what that means. But if we were going to lean on one side or the other, the right hemisphere is the one that we want to empower because the right hemisphere actually will give us a more empathetic worldview, will give us a healthier environment, will stop things like slavery and servitude and serfdom and stuff like that. Now, I feel like there may be certain groups on planet Earth that don't actually want that to occur. Leave comments if you think that that's true too. So it's kind of up to us, and that's okay. That's how it's always been anyway. That's what natural law and spiritual law actually teaches us. It's up to us. We have to make the change. We can't expect Big Brother government or Big Brother, corporations to change the name of the game for us. We have to do it. It's an inside job, so they say. So we need to get back to the place where we're recognizing our own sacred gifts and operating in our lives out of those sacred gifts. I hope you agree. If you do, comment below, tell us how you're doing that. And if you haven't gotten the free 60-page ebook that I've written, get yours now. It's free. Just click the link below. I call it the Owner's Manual Part 2. It's all about learning and knowledge. Lots of information in there. Most of these videos I make are actually written from the information that's in that book, okay? But I want to give it to you because it doesn't do me any good sitting in my Google Drive. I might as well give it away to people who are hungry for that information. The more you comment and add information, The more that you share your videos and stuff like that, the more I'll add to that book and the more videos I'll be able to do on those subjects. So I'd like to create a little network here if we can. So that was The Secret Split Within Your Brain, My Brain, and Society. I hope you found that useful. It's really important to recognize that we have these two sides to the brain and they're not as clear cut as we once thought they were. They're doing actually much more interesting things than we once thought they were. If you like this video, please smash the like button. I hate saying the word smash. If you like this video, please click the like button. Just tap it. And hit the bell if you want to get notifications. That helps our channel grow. So if you're appreciating this channel, help it grow. Share it with people. Do the YouTube stuff. Make the algorithm gods smile down upon our channel. Thank you guys for watching. We'll talk to you soon.